In this video, I'm going to cover a basic example of incremental analysis for special order. So let's look at our example. Lino Company manufactures toasters. For the first 8 months of 2014, the company reported the following operating results while operating at 75% of plant capacity. And so then we have a table that shows their sales, cost of goods sold, etc. Then we have some more information. Cost of goods sold was 70% variable and 30% fixed. Operating expenses were 75% variable and 25% fixed. In September, Lino Company receives a special order for 15,000 toasters at $7.60 each. Acceptance of the order would result in an additional $3,000 of shipping costs, but no increase in fixed operating expenses. So now we need to analyze if they should accept or reject this order. And in incremental analysis, we're only looking at the changes, so their current operations will not impact accepting or rejecting this order. So therefore, if they choose to reject the order, there's no additional revenues, no additional costs, no additional operating expenses, and therefore no impact on net income. So now we can look at whether or not they should accept the order. So in the paragraph, it tells us that the order was for 15,000 toasters at $7.60. So we need to look at what the total revenues would be just from the acceptance of that order. So we're going to take that, multiply it out, and it comes to 114,000. And we can plug that in. And since revenues would be increasing from zero if we reject to 114,000, that makes an increase in net income, so it's a positive number in our net income column. Next, we need to look at the expenses. And so the problem tells us that there will be no increase in fixed operating expenses, so we just need to find our variable. So if we look in the paragraph, it tells us that cost of goods sold was 70% variable and 30% fixed. And over on our table of data, their current cost of goods sold is 2.6 million. So if we take that 2.6 million and multiply it by the 70% variable, we can find out that their variable costs were 1,820,000. We then can take that number, divide it by the units that they had produced and sold of 350,000, to determine that the variable cost per unit for cost of goods sold is $5.20. And therefore, if they're going to produce a special order of 15,000 toasters, the variable cost of goods sold would be 78,000. And so we can plug that into our table, and since our costs would increase from zero cost of goods sold if we reject to 78,000 if we accept, that has a negative impact on net income. So in our net income column, it's also a negative number. Now we need to do the same thing for our operating expenses. So it tells us in the paragraph that our operating expenses are 75% variable and 25% fixed. So again, we take our operating expenses that they currently have of 840,000, multiply those by the 75% variable to figure out that the total variable expenses are 630,000. We take that number, divide it by the 350,000 units that they sold and produced, to determine that the variable operating expense per unit is $1.80. So if they're, again, going to do a special order of 15,000 toasters, the variable operating expenses come out to $27,000. But there's one more piece of information in that paragraph. It tells us that the order would require $3,000 of additional shipping costs. And note that that's not a per unit number, that's just a total. So we're going to take that $3,000 and add it to our operating expenses to determine that our variable operating expenses would be actually $30,000 if we accept this order. And so then we can plug it into our table. And again, we have zero operating expenses if we reject the order. We have $30,000 additional operating expenses if we accept it. And so that would have a negative impact on net income. So that's why it's shown as a negative number in our net income column. And so now we can do the math, and we can see that if they accept the order, their net income would actually increase by $6,000. And since this is a positive number, that means they would accept the order. Okay, and that's a good overall example of the analysis for accepting or rejecting a special order.